Thanks for joining us. You're watching the Fox Business Network. Let's get right at it. We've got former National Security Council Chief of Staff, former CIA analyst Fred Flights, and back with us again, former FBI Deputy Assistant Director Danny Colson, to break down these government documents about what was going on at the FBI. First to you, Fred. The emails involving Peter Strzok. Let's take this first one on. They knew in September 2016, Fred, that this whole idea that a Trump computer server was talking to a bank called Alpha Bank in Russia, that was totally wrong, that the Trump computer was, quote, inactive. But they still went a full bore on this theme anyway. The story was leaked to the media. MSNBC, CNN all ran hog wild with it when there was no there. Your reaction to that?
Well, there's several revelations like that in this recent disclosure that the FBI knew very well that the Steele dossier was bunk, but it stuck by it and used it anyway to justify a warrant to spy on the Trump campaign without telling the FISA court what this information was and how flimsy it is. That's because the FBI was out to get Donald Trump. This was not a legitimate criminal or counterintelligence investigation.
Yeah, the Democrats financed the Steele dossier.
Yes,
Danny,
that was left
the Strzok emails show Peter. Peter Strzok's emails, the new emails show that have been revealed. Strzok kept warning the FBI team, keep a lid on all the FBI leaks to the media. Protect yourselves about leaking. And then another email has Strzok saying that this debunked Steele dossier can, quote, influence the media. Your reaction to that?
Well, these people weren't confused with facts. They didn't mind leaking. They didn't mind conducting a false investigation. I think if you look at that totality of these emails, it says they knew they had nothing here, and they didn't care. They pressed forward. I wonder what academy they went to, not the one I graduated from that causes us to rely on the Constitution and collected evidence. This is horrible. It's the most disgraceful thing I've seen from anything ever happened to the FBI, ever.
Yeah, and Fred, the FBI newly revealed emails show John McCain, Senator McCain, leaking to Carl Bernstein about a dossier. We don't know if it's a Steele dossier that has since been debunked. Your reaction to that? That leak came in January 2017.
I've heard rumors of that, Liz. I'm not sure what to think about that. I don't want to speak ill of the late John McCain.
Okay, but, you know, so here's the other issue, Fred. The DOJ intelligence unit, also these government documents, and show that in December 2016, the Justice Department intelligence unit said, we're not going to support the FBI getting FISA wiretaps on Trump campaign aide George Papadopoulos. Your take on that?
Well, I mean, there was no evidence to justify spying on the Trump campaign. And there were some people in the government who were well aware of this. But John Brennan and Comey and so many others, they were out to destroy the president. And we also know from these documents that the referral that started the whole investigation in late July actually didn't start. It Strzok makes it clear that when the U.S. government got a referral from the Australian government about supposed collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia, there was already an investigation underway. And I think that's very important to understand, that the FBI and John Brennan were out to get Trump for months before that happened.
It's an interesting point that you just made, Fred, because, you know, Danny, you know how the FBI operates. This was housed inside the D.C. Bureau. Danny, the emails, the newly revealed emails, show that FBI's Peter Strzok warned really late in the game in early January that the FBI in that team in D.C. didn't have experienced espionage or prosecution officials to even do the probe. They didn't know where to house the probe inside the FBI. Was that going to be at the criminal division? Was it going to be a, quote, Trump unit rather than a Russian-influenced one, Danny? So, you know, and at that time, they knew there was no there by that time. Your reaction to that, Danny?
My reaction is, should never have been at FBI headquarters. Watergate, Iran-Contra are all run by the Washington Field Office. That's where it should go. It puts more layers of supervision, more levels of review. If you put it in the director's office, there's no review there. And so the things that went to the Department of Justice should never have gotten out of FBI headquarters. So this is a huge issue, and it one that needs to be addressed. Major cases should be run by field agents. They're not influenced by politics or power or position. When you put it at the director's office or the deputy director's office, they are influenced by that kind of stuff. And that went back to Bob Mueller. It started with him. And it's a huge problem. The FBI needs to correct it.
Yeah, Fred, Danny just makes a key point that FBI sources have told us. Because it was housed inside FBI headquarters and not at the field office, where the guys who can do the shoe leather work will just look at it, do the job, say whether or not there's anything there, it became politicized. We kept hearing from FBI officials that James Comey hopped on the train constantly, that train between headquarters to the White House, you know, talking to Obama officials. And then it became a politicized that even James Comey, Clapper, Strzok, and Lisa Page knew there was no there. They would say that later in that year of 2017. But for years we had people in the media, Democrats saying Trump did help Russia hack Democrat emails when there was no proof of that. They were talking for years that Trump was a Russian asset when there's no proof of that. So, and to this day, no one's being held accountable for that. So, Fred, my question to you is, why was it housed inside the D.C. headquarters, and did that impact the whole nature of the probe, as Danny says?
I can't answer that first question, but let me make a related remark. Why is this coming out now? Why didn't Barr put this out 6 months ago? What was the DNI doing? The American people needed this information to cast an intelligent vote, an informed vote in November. And it doesn't make any sense. I mean, frankly, I haven't followed this, Liz. It's December after the election. It's historical research now. Trump's people let him down, not getting this out 6 months ago.
We hear what you're saying. Danny, your final word. I mean, we've been hearing for years people in the media speaking authoritatively as if it's a fact that Trump was a Russian asset when that was wrong, when there was no proof of that whatsoever. And there was no proof that Trump helped Russia hack Democrat emails. We do have talk of, you know, when government documents showing Hillary Clinton's team went after Trump trying to link him to this, you know, when using the Steele and financing the Steele dossier. Your final word, Danny.
Well, first of all, this needs to come out. This needs now, accountability needs to come forth here. We're going to see if Mr. Durham has the courage to go forward this thing and get this thing done. Because if they violated the law, and I think they did civil rights violations, a lot of things, we can't change the facts, but we can now hold them accountable. And I'm praying that Mr. Durham will do that.
All right, Fred Flights and Danny Colson, you guys have been great tonight. We like this new tag team of you two. Maybe we'll do it again. It's good to see you. Glad you enjoyed it. Coming up.